visualization. So firstly, let me introduce some background. This project is designed in the context of lecture and tutorial. Students are assessing online resources. And as many of you are lecturers and tutors, and you may understand the feedback of the students is actually very important, and you may need to obtain it clearly and straightly as soon as possible. And that's what we talk about here. This project is based on a learning resources website called Reoffering. It's made of a Python-based documentation generation framework called Sphinx, and it can generate customizable HTML pages. And you can see it is the restructured text file, and all the contents are defined in this file, and it can be converted into HTML files. Just like that, it's pretty much similar as the Flip website using our Unity. But there are some problems remain in this kind of system because it is a one-way instilling, which means the lecturer just talking by himself, and the students are pretty far away, and he is not able to know how the students doing during the lecture. It may result in low engagement, and as well there's no further analysis during this process. So to address this, a solution is to add a real-time feedback module which is visualized and can be easily assessed, and all the results will be recorded for further analytics. So let's move on to the next part, the requirements. On the system level, the requirements can be divided into three sections, namely the front end, the customization module, and the data collection system. On the user level, both the teacher and students can view and interact with the learning resource system, and the teachers will be provided with the analytic results, and also he can customize the pages, and the admin staffs can assess the data stored at the back end. There are also some non-functional requirements, namely the efficiency, stability, scalability, and data integrity. For example, the system should remain stable and function normally within 100 concurrent access, and the system should be able to be extended with some additional modules written in Python. And here are some diagrams. This is the use case diagram. And this is the entity relationship, which the data module are defined based on it. And let's move on to the next session, the implementation. This is a bunch of the technologies and dependencies used in this project. And this is the overall structure of the system. You can see this part is the customization modules, which may contain some RST files and other resources for generating the HTML files, which constructed the front end. And there are also some features defined in the statics modules, which contain some JS files and style sheets. Supports just the presentation. It has nothing to do with the data. So I just create the request handler for retrieving and sending data. And on the other side, there is a data collection system. And you can see there is also a request handler there, but it has written in completely different methods based on different dependencies. So it's an independent system running on another server. So the data transmits between is on a cross-domain level. And there are also some other modules for manipulating data and the database. Next, let me introduce some methods for data handling. As you know, I have mentioned just now, it is actually the system is actually made of some clue of front end stuff, and it has nothing to do with the database. So the way to handle the data is to retrieve it in some JS script and send it via AJS methods. And since it is a cross-domain transmission, the data format is JSONP.
3 minutes to go.
Okay. For the general request handler, there is no difference in handling JSON and JSONP data. But for JS request handler, it is a little bit tricky because when we define the request that expects data type of JSONP format, it cannot resolve any other type of data other than JSONP. So which means we need to define action methods for converting the data into JSONP formats. And there is no such requirement in Django can be used. So I just wrote a method to construct a callback function like string as the padding in JSONP and use as a container to carry the load on the send side. And the constructed function should be consistent to the JSON callback function defined in the receiver side. And instead of hard coding, I extract this method into a decorator, which is similar as the annotation in Java. And in case we need to extend this project, we can just convert data into JSONP format by simply adding a decorator in front of the specific functions, so it would be better for scalability. And some specific methods are defined in Django-based backend to process, analyze, and manipulate the data. And all the data will be stored in the database. In this case, I use MySQL. And there is also an admin interface for the admin staff to observe the data. So in the visualization part, the result is written in JS, and it is stored in the static modules, which remains consistent when the HTML file is regenerated. So you can see there currently we have two types of results can be built.
1 minute.
Okay, basically the statics and the bar chart. And the chart is created by an open source chart learning tool called S-chart. So let's move on to the demo part and see how it actually works. Students can interact with the system and their interaction will be recorded. And this is how the admin can view the data at the back end. You can also manipulate the data in the database. And this is how the teachers can view the analytical results.